Hello, this is the Provoked Prawn, and this is an unusual video on how to convert a PSA 1 from Rode, which is a boom arm that's technically meant for microphones, into a camera mount. Now, I did this video as an interesting alternative to doing an unboxing video on the PSA 1, but I'm going to use it to be able to talk about the highlights of this boom arm and what it's like to use. I'm also going to do a video soon in the near future to compare the Rode PSA 1 with the Blue Compass, which has been my go-to and favorite for a long time. But as you can see from this initial shot, it's actually really easy to use the PSA 1 as a DSLR camera mount and be able to get the camera into multiple different positions and capture footage. And the reason I'm using that is to be able to do top-down shots, but also capture from a multitude of angles. And it's actually possible to do some interesting slightly smooth panning shots in this way as well, which I'll show later on in the video. And so if you're an aspiring content creator or are just looking for a way to mount a camera in an interesting way, perhaps you're a streamer and you want to be able to reposition your camera multiple times, then this might be an option. Now the PSA 1 is a not inexpensive but not overly expensive boom arm. It is cheaper than the Blue Compass and so more accessible, but it's also sturdy and trusted by many. The box comes with a number of different things for easy, straightforward installation. You have this standard bracket mount which basically screws onto your desk. You have this gold threaded adapter which basically means that you can adjust the setup so that you can set it on a number of different microphones. And you have this bracket which is intended to be installed on your desk. So if you want a more permanent installation, you can drill a hole or make a hole in your desk, put this inside it, thread that screw on the bottom, and then have a more permanent attachment, which might be a more stable option. But I'll be honest, this is £400 worth of American walnut that I'm not willing to butcher for the sake of an experiment. So here I am using the standard mounting thread system, which is pretty straightforward and easy to do. You'll see it has a rubber base plate, so it basically won't damage the top of the desk, but might do some damage to the underneath with this little metal setup. The boom arm itself then has a small thread which sits inside there. And then on the other end of that, obviously, you have the mount for the microphone, which is adjustable in a few different ways, and it does tilt and turn in a satisfying way. It feels good quality and hefty out of the box and seemed like it was going to be a good replacement from the very cheap and flimsy one that it had already installed. Now I was using this one, which was purchased and actually sold as a option to mount a smartphone on, and so it's a sort of flimsy lightweight boom arm that wasn't really intended for microphones but was actually designed to work with cameras because it comes with a ball head mount on the end of it. And I've been using that with my DSLR, but the problem is it's a bit flimsy, and although it does kind of stay in place, some of the footage come out a bit wobbly and it's a bit unreliable in getting it to stay up. So I wanted to upgrade and try something a bit sturdier, and that's where the Rode PSA 1 comes in. And also it's potentially an option to be able to compare with the Compass boom arm, like I said, and also just to be able to talk about it in general and do a video on that. So I'll be doing those bits of content in the near future, but I wanted to be able to show you the differences between the two. So as I said, this cheaper one comes with this nifty little ball mount, and that's something that this boom arm has over the PSA 1, because that adapter allows you to move your camera or smartphone into a number of different positions with ease. You can see you just twist one knob and then you can move the ball around and adjust it simply, but I'm going to show a different solution for that as we go into this video. Now the PSA 1, as I said, mounts like this as standard. If you don't want to drill a hole in your desk, you can basically put this mount on top and then tighten it up underneath. And as you can see, it's a fairly sturdy looking base and quite chunky, but the bit that actually plugs into it from the boom arm itself is a bit thinner. And so I was a bit concerned, I'll be honest, when I initially started out, that it was still going to be quite wobbly. And I was also shocked by just how sort of springy the arm is. When you initially get out of the box, it sort of springs up and out of the way. And although you can move it around a lot, as you can see here, which is certainly full of promise, as soon as I let go, it basically popped up in the air and shot away from me out of control. But the reason for that is, so if you have this issue, don't panic. It basically needs some weight on it to keep it in place. Now, this boom arm can hold up to 2 kilograms of weight, although other people have claimed to be able to put more on it. And I'm going to mount it with a ball head by the end of this and a DSLR camera with a microphone attached to it. and in that position it actually works quite well. Now, a quick bit on the microphone setup. So as standard, there's two thread options. Basically, you have the standard silver thread as installed here, and then you have this adapter. And I'll mention in the description all the specifications, you get an idea of the sizes. But here we have a Blue Yeti microphone, just to show how that works. So you need the larger thread mount for this, for the adapter, and then it just screws in there. And once that's in place, it stays in place nicely. And obviously, once you put the cables and everything else on it, it'll be even better. And you can adjust it into the right position for where you'd be using it if you were using it as a microphone arm. And you can see a fairly sturdy design from it here. It's very flexible and easy to put into a number of different places. But what I did note is that it does spring up. Now, there are some tensioning screws, so you can adjust that. But that is not the purpose of this video. No, here I'm going to be showing you something else. Now, using that same adapter, I'm also going to show you how you can purchase an extra additional adapter which allows you to install your camera straight on the thread mount for the microphone. So that gold adapter then attaches to this. Now, this isn't included in the PSA box. It is an extra purchase, but it isn't an expensive one. I'll link to that in the description. It cost me about £5, which is somewhere between $7 and $10, depending on where you're from. And you can see that just screws on top of that. What that does is then it converts that bottom screw thread into the right size for a camera. So the camera will then screw in there with relative ease. Now, of course, this is pretty static. You can adjust it in the same way you would a microphone, so you can use that, but it does sort of stay in the same place. The other option is spring for a ball head mount. Now, so here I have a Manfrotto one, and I'll link again in the description so you can check that out. There are various different options available, but this is a ball head with a quick release plate that you attach to the camera, and it then allows you to adjust in more directions, and it has a bit more flexibility. Also adds some extra weight to the boom arm, obviously, which increases the stability from what I've seen. But more importantly, it gives you the ability to put it into more angles, which will allow for a lot more easy shots in terms of going top down or side on views. And stick with me, because I'll show you some content that I've captured with the boom arm already to show that it does work and it is really nice. Now, what won't happen here is you won't be able to mount it like this. So I initially thought the adapter would work with this, but actually no, it doesn't. The ball head mount actually sits on this standard thread that comes with the microphone. So it's the same size as a standard microphone thread. So that's great. You can basically attach the ball head to this with ease, and you don't need to pay the extra for that adapter. Yes, you need to pay for the ball head and the boom arm, but once you've done that, you then have the best setup. There's a little adapter underneath that you can then tighten up once you've got your ball head in to the right position. And obviously you can adjust that and make sure it's as tight as possible. That silver dial on the right-hand side of the PSA also allows you to adjust the position. So you could have got multiple options for adjusting the setup of that. You then put the quick release plate from the Manfrotto ball head on your camera and then slot them into place and click it down and then lock it in place. And once you've done that, you're away. Now, it is worth noting there are a number of different ball head options out there. You could obviously get a much cheaper one. Manfrotto is slightly more expensive, but they do offer some really premium gear that's well worth looking at. And personally, I'm looking for a better solution for better video capture. But if you're not going to be moving the camera around a lot and you're going to have it in a static position maybe, or if you're not bothered about getting perfectly still shots or from multiple different angles, then you might not need to bother with a ball head. You could just use the adapter and have a static shot. What you can see though is it gives a lot more flexibility in terms of where you position the camera, not only thanks to the length and movement of the boom arm, which is now a lot more stationary now it's got some weight on it, but also thanks to that ball head setup, which allows for adjustment into a variety of positions. One of the main things I'll be using it for is top down shots. This allows me to have top down without having to worry about a ceiling mount or a wall mount or anything like that. It is worth noting, of course, that this still isn't perfectly stable. You'll have noticed when I've been moving it around that it does have some camera shake in it, and any knocks that you get on the desk are potentially going to carry through into the camera. So not perfect, but it is a lot more stable and a lot more flexible than the cheap one that I had from Amazon. So this has been a nice upgrade. If a bit more money, probably looking at somewhere around 150 for the whole package, I'd say. Obviously that doesn't include the camera, but then you can see just the multitude of different angles and positions that you can get into in relatively quick time, and it's a lot less hassle than trying to set up a tripod and get that into the same position. So just to demonstrate, here's a few shots with the boom arm captured in a number of different positions. So you can see here, basically I've got the boom arm off to a slight angle on my left hand side, quite low down, and so it gives another nice shot. Then going into a top down shot from above, same boom arm, same setup, just repositioned and using the ball head, I've put it in a better position to be able to demonstrate what I'm trying to show here with the Astro A50, which is going to be a separate video coming shortly if you're interested in that. I've also done a behind the scenes video on how I capture this sort of footage and the thinking behind it, so if you're interested, please check out my behind the scenes playlist and the videos linked in the description. You might find that interesting. But one of the things I realized while doing this setup is that because of the sturdiness of the boom arm, if you're gentle and you have capable hands and you're able to do smooth-ish movements without putting too much shake into the camera, it is actually possible to use the boom arm setup like this to put a bit of pan and movement into your shot, so it doesn't have to be static necessarily. It did take a few tries to get this right because you have to get the right angle. It's fairly difficult to adjust it to make it move smoothly across. If it's not a smooth left and right pan, but it is a pretty interesting curve round from the side, and you can see me putting it into action here, and this is the final result. Now you'll notice there is a little bit of judder in it. I haven't done any video stabilization in it or anything like that, but I could add those in to improve the shot. But you can see what this does is it opens up a world of different possibilities in terms of the capture, and so I think this is a really good option, especially if you're limited in space. I actually have three different tripods in my room, and now I basically don't have to use all of them. I've got one with a slider on it, I've got another one that's obviously capturing this footage, and then I've got the boom arm now, so you don't need to worry about multiple different tripods set up in different positions. And I can use this for multi angle camera capture, so if you're ever wondering how I have multiple shots in my videos, this is how I usually do it, with the boom arm taken from one position, my main camera taken from another, and then cutting those shots up. But you can see with this setup I should be able to get some even better shots from more angles and a lot more stable. So there you go, the Rode PSA 1 set up as a camera mount instead of a microphone mount. Hopefully you found this video useful. Let me know in the comments if you've got any questions, and stick around for the versus video comparing it with the Blue Compass. Thanks for watching.
This has been the Provoked Prawn. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Hope you found it useful, interesting, hilarious, or all of the above. Be sure to check out the description for other information you might find interesting, and subscribe and watch these other videos as well that I think might be useful to you, and have a great life.